Hello guys, it's Jordan from Jordan Orchid Review. Welcome back. Today we'll be talking about an IEM from EPZ. So it's called a G10. But thank you EPZ for sending this IEM over, but it will not affect my honest opinion on it. And before I start, let's talk about the name. So it's G10. Yes, Golf 10. But why? Yeah, so it's just to me a bit awkward because your name is EPZ. And you put a G10, yeah, not very cool. But because maybe due to it's a 10 millimeter driver, I guess. What stands for G? I think it's for gaming. Okay, just guessing. Because this is what they will advertise as. This is a gaming IEM. But I find it's not just a regular gaming IEM. So, you know, nowadays, Chi-Fi market has been so competitive, okay? Under $50 you can get like 100 over IEMs, and every week you get new releases non-stop. Okay, is the market here is so saturated, it's so competitive, but occasionally there are some one or two model that will actually breaks the market. So for last year 2023, the one that I think that broke the market was from SimGod, the EW200. Then now, I got this G10. While I thought that the EW200 is unbeatable, but suddenly I got the G10. It's not saying that the G10 is better than the EW200 or the EW200 is massively nicer than this G10, but I just find that, wow, there are good stuff in this price point. So first of all, let's talk about the shell, the physical aspect of this IEM. Same thing again from EPZ, at least the last one that I tried, I believe that was called the K1. And this G10 is super comfortable to wear. They are small, okay? Even the K1 last time was small, very small. So for you guys who like to have a smaller IEM that it will not jacks up too much, then something for you to consider. And also the faceplate on it is carbon fiber. First thing is resin shell, and the faceplate is carbon fiber. Most importantly, at this price point, you get metal nozzle. Wow, right? So it's good, okay, it's good. And also, let's talk about design a little bit. Just that something that I would like to nitpick about. So this whole thing is quite nice looking, as in carbon fiber, you can't go wrong with carbon fiber faceplate. But the G, the logo G here, is kind of fine as well. But putting the G and then next to it, we have an EPZ letter. So to me, on this so tiny little space that you can have on this IEM, just a little bit too crowded. Okay, just a little bit too much. Yeah, to be frank, I don't really like letters a lot. That's why I've been nitpicking so much. So, but still, it's quite good looking. Yeah, it's gold color, right? And also another little things to play about is that this thing is you can glow in the dark, yes, but you need to like put it under the sun or put it under torchlight for a while, then it will glow in green. But you in normal use case, okay, yes, just things to gimmicks to play with, because usually you won't be exactly going under the sun and suddenly go to a very dark place to listen to your music, I guess. But still, yeah, good to have. Okay, it's interesting. So, and the cable that they have given, yes, this cable, I think one of the biggest selling point of this IEM, it has mic. Okay, for people that are like using $200, $300 IEM, of course you guys would want to avoid anything with mic, because it will just affect the aesthetic of the design. Okay, having mic is just meh, correct? But for IEM at this price point, around like $40, when you have a mic, it really save you a lot of hassle, like try to get an external mic, or this will enable you to really use it as a gaming earphone. That's why it's called G10 gaming. Okay, so it's a really really good features that I find on budget IEM, because you can just grab it to go, okay, and play games whatever you want, and also at the same time talk to your teammates if you needed to or you can also use this for meetings, I would guess. Okay, if you are using, you need a good earbuds, earphone in the office that is not too big, not too chunky, and also the cable is very easy to handle with mic. There you go. You don't need to buy the separate cable anymore. It's biggest selling point on this, really. So even though it's just a little mic, which can be, it's not some revolutionary technology, but just really I find it very useful. At least I would use this on the PS5 to play games with my friends. Why not? Okay, so comfortable to wear and it's nice sounding. So let's talk about the sound. And this is what surprised me a lot, because there are so many brands out there. There are so many brands with letters out there. So most of the time they just sounded average. Okay, sounded average because it's just really too much of them. And this really stand out a little bit more than the rest of them because it sounded to me nice. Okay, you can look at the graph where I would just check it around here. Yeah, so it's, I would say, very balanced sounding. You have good amount of bass and also good amount of vocal presentations and then presence also. So it's kind of a little bit near to the signature of the EW200. So both of them having this a little bit warmish in the lower end, and also the vocals will stand quite forward like what I usually like to, and treble is not overly sharp as well. But I would say, to listen to most of the genres out there, this IM is quite versatile. I would say it's quite versatile. The bass is there, vocal is there, and everything else not too overly sibilant or sharp, or sounded a little bit too digital, I would say, too grainy. Just that this is a very all-rounder IM. Yes, it is good. And for you guys out there, if you have the EW200, do you need to get this? I would say maybe not, but if you need the mic, yes, you need to get this because it's not too overly expensive. If you buy a separate mic outside, it may already cost you like $40, but this have a mic and a good sounding IM. Yes, this quite, I really like the sound of this IM quite a bit, because it's not too, I would say, because some of the IM are just way too bassy or just way too sharp. Most of the time, this just hit the right spot and the right price point, and have the biggest feature of having a mic. So, and that's all for the review I have for this G10. And if you want, really want me to nitpick, I would say maybe it need a little bit more technical, I would say technicalities of it. So if you want like more details here and there, if you want a little bit better imaging, this and that, it is not really there. Okay, because seeing that this is a 1 dB IM at a budget price point, yeah, it's not there, but then it's not really bad. Okay, just average. So gaming, does it have like pinpoint laser, pinpoint imaging? Not quite as well, just that it's not bad. Okay, it's not bad. If I were to go with gaming with really good imaging but not too overly expensive, like I want, like, you know, everyone exactly where they are, I need to go up my price point to at least orchestra light, that kind. Yeah, but it's too overly expensive, and this is a little bit more budget friendly with mic. Again, with mic, if you have PS5, not sure whether Switch would it work on this, because it's just 3.5. okay, I guess it would. So PS5, Switch user, or just general phone user that playing games, Mobile Legend, that you need to shout across to other team or your teammates, there you go. Okay, so that's all for the review today. See you guys. Bye-bye.